shall we? Let's go. Well then. Shall we?
Let's go.
Well then.
It's time.
You seated yourselves and called for a stein of the finest mead. Your partner, Ranny, is in a particularly good mood. Quaffing the bar's spirits buoyed your spirits. When things are lively, Ranny will recount a certain tale. You were an adventurer, just starting out, and didn't know right from left. It was then that you first met.
They're coming.
"Shall I open that door for you?" the rogue Ranny inquired, after appearing from out of nowhere. He thought that it would be a simple matter to take advantage of your naivete and pocket some coin.
"It's my turn. Done." Let's see.
Oh, yeah.
Since that point, you've been journeying under mutually beneficial terms. You handle combat, and Ranny handles locks.
Oh, yeah!
Okay!
All right!
You need the 9 talismans to defeat the ancient dragon. Lucane tried his best to fix the broken black runestone, but the task was beyond his capabilities. Without the gate, you cannot enter the illusionary lands. Even with all the talismans, you'll be unable to stop the dragon. There isn't a spirit left that could create a rune like this. The runes only survived by being used sparingly. Haven't you seen this rune somewhere, though? Seek it. Once you find it, you can reach the illusionary lands.
Oh, which one?
Samuel says that he needs to talk to you. As an experienced adventurer, he wishes to impart some advice to you. He says you must be prepared. He gives you a pack so you can organize yourself. If you feel like you require more organization, you can purchase more packs from Morgan's shop.
You're back.
Thank you. Many things lie within the ruins of the old Elysian temple. Some quiescent, some far less so. An ancient dragon, spoken of in myths, is said to have destroyed the Elysian civilization in one night.
It's my turn.
Done.
By the time you arrive at the battle, Roland has already vanquished the last of the foes. He lives up to his let. Roland works through this region. Which path will you take?
Very wary of Medusa's eyes. Anyone who meets her gaze is turned to stone.
To avoid suffering a stony fate, you must not look into her eyes. If you find the going difficult, consider ducking into a building to recuperate. Medusa turns to stone and crumbles into dust. This act of vengeance should assuage some of the anger of those unfortunate souls that she petrified. At sundown, you and your party gather around the campfire. Eat well, for you will need to be prepared for the day ahead.
Yeah!
Thank you.
After your meal, you lay down to rest. Another dangerous mission. This underground labyrinth was created by the magician Wallace in a single night. It is said that fearsome monsters are held captive in the depths of this hazardous, trap-filled maze. Suddenly, a rodent darts out and begins talking. Ricky, the magician's apprentice, needs your help once again. He says that wayward wizards have waylaid the labyrinth again. There must be a reason mages keep attacking. Which path will you take? You learn that the labyrinth was built to contain the Cyclopes.
They're here!
Pursue the magician with the key. They must be trying to open the door to the prison. spot the stolen key lying next to the crushed corpse of the magician. It's clear how he met his demise. The door to the prison is wide open. If you shut the door before the other Cyclopes stampede, you may still have a chance to control the situation. Put the key in the keyhole in front of the cell to contain the Cyclopes. The Cyclopes are furiously resisting your attempts to close the door. The Cyclopes are furiously resisting your attempts to close the door. You were able to lock and seal the Cyclopes prison once again. Ricky, the magician's apprentice, is elated and gives you a handsome reward. In the age of the gods, mankind built a giant tower in a sacred place in an attempt to reach the world of the gods. That arrogance angered the gods, and it is said that the entire city was leveled.
What?
You meet a female warrior monk who was injured in the battle against the demons. She was sent to purify this sanctuary. A ritual to summon the demon king is underway. She must place the holy seal in the temple to seal the demon. Which path will you take? To prevent the resurrection of the Demon King, you decide to stop the threat at the source by crushing the ritual. The Demon Realm's breaching of the Human Realm is causing an earthquake, and the ruins are crumbling. The magic circle you discovered is most likely being used as part of the ritual. You accidentally touched the magic circle and have been transported to the demon realm. The Demon King is still struggling to break free from his bindings. With his power sealed, you may still be able to banish the Demon King. The Demon King shouts bitter invectives at you until judgment has been rendered upon it once again. Unfortunately, the next highest ranking demon then appeared, hot on your heels. Prevented the Demon King's resurrection and assisted in defeating his top demon, the Archdemon. The town temple will certainly inscribe your name as a savior to be remembered throughout the ages. You obtained the green talisman. You obtained the aqua talisman. You obtained the blue talisman. You need 6 more talismans to defeat the ancient dragon.
You're back. Request. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Gotta finish my drink.
You need 6 more talismans to defeat the ancient dragon. These are the ruins of the ancient capital city. It was destroyed following an invasion from the Northern Empire. Now it is a dangerous place, full of dragons and wyverns. Tommit is surprised by the sudden nature of the red dragons. Which path will you take? The area reeks of sulfur, and earth-shaking snoring reverberates throughout. When you're ready, move forth.
I got it.
The red dragon is nigh. The dragon has awoken from its slumber.
How bothers
is waiting to unleash its fiery breath. Ready your shields! To unleash its fiery breath. Ready your shields! Waiting to unleash its fiery breath. Ready your shields! defeated the Red Dragon, said to be the strongest creature known to man. Your name will command respect for all time. Bear your new title proudly, Dragon Slayer. At sundown, you and your party gather around the campfire. Eat well, for you will need to be prepared for the day ahead. After your meal, you lay down to rest. Another dangerous mission awaits you tomorrow. The Mage's Tower, once greatly admired by magicians as a bastion of wisdom. It now embodies all the fears Hydeland has of being conquered by the rebel forces which conspire against it.
Filthy Luca! Oh, I can do that. Filthy Luca!
Be careful!
The followers of Morneon seem to be capturing as many spirits and fairies as they can find to power their rune magic. The spirit tells you about the terrible experiments going on in this tower. It seems that they're fusing monsters together. Which path will you take? You can access the laboratory in the upper levels of the tower by using the hidden elevator.
Yeah.
It's a dead end. There don't seem to be any stairs or pathways. The frantic researcher seems to have abandoned his experimentation and run off. The contents of the beaker are shaking uncontrollably. The floorboards are creaking loudly. They feel as if you could put a hole through them at any moment. Chimera, unable to move around in such a confined space, died, curled up on itself. The continued production of these monsters will only cause great harm to the kingdom. Lost woods are so vast and similar looking that you quickly lose track of where you are. It is said that only the hermit who lives here actually knows the way out of this forest. Sensing a presence, you turn around. You see a man standing on a rock.
Two paths leave the forest, he shouts. The path of the coward and the path of glory.
Which path will you take? You have heard rumors of the violent monster before. Many northern knights lost their lives challenging this beast.
Thank you.
The terrifying killer rabbit has breathed its last, thanks to your efforts. A familiar voice congratulates you, saying, "Now glory is yours." The inside of the cave connects to a fissure on the coastline. It seems large enough to contain another ocean. Sailors dread passing through this area. There are myriad tales of ships disappearing here.
What?
A beautiful voice in the sea calls out to you. You'd heard of the mermaid's legendary curiosity. She asks you many questions. She wandered into these shallow waters after being chased by a kraken. She says the kraken should still be nearby. Which path will you take? The kraken lurks in the cave and attacks ships that pass through the area. You throw caution to the wind and fling your party headlong into a confrontation against the kraken.
How bothersome.
The stranded ship starts moving. Something is pulling the ship from beneath the water. The tentacles grasp hold of the mast. If this continues, the ship will capsize. Tentacles grasp hold of the mast. If this continues, the ship will capsize.
Yeah.
Wounded Kraken flees deep into the cave. Now is your chance. You inch closer to the Kraken's lair. The Kraken has wrapped its tentacles around stalactites and is trying to destroy the cave. Strike a death blow to the Kraken that had been terrorizing the sea. Many sailors will certainly raise a toast in your honor once word of your victory gets out. At sundown, you and your party gather around the campfire. Eat well, for you will need to be prepared for the day ahead. After your meal, you lay down to rest. Another dangerous mission awaits you tomorrow. The Orc army presently controls Bilberon, the underground fortress built into the canyon. The king's army has been mounting a fierce offensive to try and reclaim the fortress. You step into the enemy kitchen. She seems to be mistaking you for a hungry Which path will you take? The king's army, in trying to breach the impregnable gargoyle gate, is suffering many casualties. You decide to join in the skirmish and support the king's army's attempt to break through the gate.
Outstanding. Filthy Luca.
You step into the bloody chaos, where both armies are exchanging blows and cannon fire. Just beyond here is the notorious Gargoyle Gate. A gate this solid cannot be destroyed without a massive cannon. Use the King's Army's cannon to breach it. cannon. Kill off the enemies before they can destroy it. Cracks forming in the venerable gargoyle gate. The soldiers of the King's army praise you and your team for conquering an important gate of the underground fortress. The fight will continue until the fortress is regained. In the catacombs, stark white bones are strewn about the ground as far as the eye can see. The sheer number of the deceased is the only indication left of this area's former prosperity. A strange knight stumbles out of the knight is muttering to himself. You strain your ears, but all you can make out is the death god is coming. Which path will you take? When you step onto the walkway, the knight disappears like smoke.
What?
The path back is inaccessible. The situation leaves you anxious. Must find an escape route. Wraiths are invincible, and you have no hope of defeating them. To overcome the power of the Death God, you must rely on the goddess to save you. Only the light shone by the angel statue will expose the Wraith's weakness.
They're here!
Divine light shines forth, exposing the Wraith's only weakness, the Dreamer.
Yeah.
The divine light fades, and hopelessness once again darkens your heart. Divine light shines forth, exposing the Wraith's only weakness, the Dream Heart. Destroy the Dream Heart and send the Wraith back to the underworld. You cannot destroy death, the opposite of life. You should rejoice in the fact you even still draw breath. You obtained the red talisman. You obtained the orange talisman. You obtained the yellow talisman. You obtained the purple talisman. You obtained the white talisman. You obtained the black talisman. Do you remember the runes that Lucain mentioned? These secret runes will open the gate to the Illusionary Lands.
Oh, yeah!
Okay!
All right!
Welcome to my shop. What would you like? Which one do you want? What would you like?
You're back.
This game is so cool. I just actually recently put the book art of the game.
You step forth into the illusionary lands. The goddess's powers of resurrection cannot reach you here.
Actually, I'm playing the pro version. The pro version is the one that came on PlayStation 4. The first version came on Vita and PlayStation 3. The only difference, I think, it's high resolution, and there is like a different soundtrack. Like, you can choose between the original soundtrack that was released like 4 or 5 years back and the orchestrated version. So other than that, it's exactly the same game, apart from the music and the HD graphics, that's it. That's the only difference. So if you own the old one, you don't need to buy the new one. Unless you like, you wanna, like, you have 4K TV, and maybe that will make it a little bit of difference.
The talismans are resonating in your path. The fate of the world is literally in your hands. Go, seize the day. Dragon's breath immolates everything. Take cover!
Oh.
With a ground-shaking thud that parts the clouds, the ancient dragon falls. You have returned it to its eternal sleep. The immortal dragon slumbers once again. Congratulations, hero. With your own hands, you have defeated a myth.
Yes, yeah, very good. This company is like pretty known for like for their works. If you play, there is other games that looks similar to this one. There's let me check. There is Odin Sphere. That's an action RPG, so it's pretty much the same way. It plays almost the same way, but it's like straight line of instead of like 2.5D. Or like say isometric 3D, so it's not the same. It's like just go back and forth. You don't like go like in depth. There's also I forgot the name, Maramusa or something like that. Vanillaware. Yeah, there's also Muramasa. Yeah. That's an action RPG too, but it's just like it's almost the same kind of game, but I think better combat system too, but in Japanese setting. It's on I think the Wii. Yeah, it came first on the Wii, after that on the Vita. I'm not sure if it's on the Switch. Maybe it's also on the Switch. Let me check. Yeah, Vita, Wii U. That's the only platforms that you can play this game with. Yeah. Odin Sphere is almost on every system. It's on the Vita, on PlayStation 3, on PS2. And maybe even on PS4. There is a they released like a couple of years back. Version on PS4, PS3, PS2 and Vita, yeah, every PlayStation platform. Unfortunately not on the Switch. There is so many other games. Those three are the most famous ones. Yeah. I think the best one is Odin Sphere. It's way longer to finish and has a way better story and like five different characters, I think, if I'm not mistaken. And each character is like different campaign, so you play this guy, you see this story from his point of view. It's like the same story but told from different perspectives. Odin Sphere is very, very good game. This one I'll say, like if somebody say, oh, it's not good, yeah, I can get it. It's because it's like almost like 90s arcade game. Odin Sphere is more like 2D action RPG with really, really good story. Odin Sphere, yeah, check that one. It's very good. If you never played it, that's a game to play. Okay, we're done with the main. I'll go back to the Amazon and try to finish the hard boss.
The dragon's crown lay near the ancient dragon. It was the cause of this incident, but you can make it a symbol of hope. Without the demons, this is just an ordinary crown. However, the minds of the people have ascribed great power to it. you kneel to offer the dragon's crown to the new queen, Vivian. The crown of the Elysian king fits her well. With the legendary crown, the royal scepter, and orb, none can deny her rightful ascension to the throne. The dragon's crown will be a symbol of power, inspiring fear in the hearts of any who would threaten Hydland. It represents the fact that warriors who defeated the mightiest foes reside in Hydland and will rise to defend it from any threat. Queen Vivian invites you to work at the castle. You value your freedom, so you politely decline. However, you vow to work for the queen whenever the need may arise. In turn, she blesses you with the royal favor for life. As you exit through the Great Gate, many soldiers turn and salute. You have completed a legendary accomplishment. Queen Vivian would lead Hydland well, reclaiming its past borders and reasserting itself as a powerful nation.
Candies for life, yeah. Every time, every day. Every day candies. For free, for life.
The tale of the Dragon's Crown ends here. Despite accomplishing enough for myriad lifetimes, your story is just beginning. An arrogant young magician was attempting to save his sister's life by tinkering with immortality spells beyond his ken. Worry became elation as you saw your sister drift into a deep sleep, obviously free of the pain that plagued her every moment. Sadly, your joy was fleeting. She neither breathed nor woke again. Your spell left her in limbo, neither alive nor dead. Your journey was a quest to save her from your foolish actions. You traveled the world before ending up at Hydland. Now you return as a great magician to fix your error. You distilled the ancient dragon blood to create the elixir.